What's up, everyone? Here to do the Breaker New Waves, chapter 129. And this week's chapter, it wasn't a bad chapter. I actually enjoyed it because we just got some information and we sum up the battle from before. But like I said, not a bad chapter. I enjoyed it, but I'll let you guys know exactly what I thought about it now. So the chapter begins with Shiwon just waking up because we know he's went through a hell of a lot. And he actually doesn't know what's going on, and Jenny's calling his name, and after that we go to like everyone else's view, and apparently Sang-seok patches him up, and because we know before he admits that he lost. And right after that, man, I didn't know his name before, but I had to look it up. His name is Lae-won, because I hate this guy. The guy from the government with the glasses. He doesn't know how to handle the situation, because he's hoping that Shiwon won't wake up, and he can try to defuse it, because obviously this is a mess. And he tries to tell Elder Kwan that they did this out of concern, and they were just looking out for his health, and a lot was going on with the police and the Sunwoo, and they didn't have time to take him to them, so they just planned on healing him. But we obviously know that was crap. And as soon as he keeps on trying to explain it, man, Shiwon wakes up, and man, he asks him, "Hey, what did you say?" And he tries to lie, and Elder Kwan was like, "Hey, do you want to die? The Gaju just asked you something." And right after that, he tries to lie again, and Shiwon was like, "Hey, like, keep it real, be honest." And this guy, like, he has a little bit of inner dialogue, and I thought this was interesting because we all knew that Shiwon had a strong presence, but with, like, obviously his ki back and other elements involved, he's a lot more confident now, seems like, because he can use martial arts. I don't know, man. His presence seems honestly stronger than ever before, and I really like that. And right after that, this guy is just so shook. He actually says something in the chapter like, was he ever so big? Because his presence was so strong, and he said his eyes were strong also. And this guy just pretty much bitches up and starts apologizing and saying he's sorry. And right after that, Shiwon tells him, "Hey, if you ever do that again, I won't let it go so easy." And we get some inner dialogue from Lae-won, and he is pissed. He is like, "Oh my gosh, this little brat." Like, he thinks he's cool because he's with the Sunwoo clan. Like, he is just mad because he just got punked by a kid, pretty much. And right after that, Lae-won also says that Shiwon is unpredictable, and that apparently you don't know what will happen around him, and as that's been proven in the series, you really don't know. And right after that, Sang-seok ends up talking to Elder Kwan a little bit, and Kwan tells him that if the Murom gets a hold of this, like, this will be a mess, pretty much. And Sang-seok says, "I have no knowledge of the rebirth technique. I don't know what you're talking about," which gained a lot more respect from me, at least. And right after that, he says he's sorry, and like, we all expect Kwan to, like, because we know how serious he is, like, kind of get mad or not apologize back, but he ends up saying thank you from the elder of the Sunwoo clan. And after that, the physician says, "I'm sorry about what happened to Lady Soul," and raise the Gaju well. And that pretty much sums up the chapter. Like I said, not a lot happened, but it was still enjoyable just because we finally summed up this situation, because this battle's been going on for about, I think, about around 18 chapters now, maybe 17. But either way, I'm ready to get out of there. Don't get me wrong, I hope there's not like a huge time skip, but I do want to skip maybe over like a couple weeks to where Shiwon's healed and maybe training with Elder Kwan. And I also want to discuss some things that I'm looking forward to in the series. I definitely, like, in my opinion, I'm so ready to see him meet Nine Arch Dragon again, or his master, because, like, it just makes me wonder how he will react. And we've been anticipating this the whole entire series, and I don't know if you guys know this, if it's your first time watching these reviews, the series will actually be over before this year, and I guess they're going to start part three of The Breaker, so I'm just pretty curious on where they're going to, like, end this series off with, because I feel like if they're, like, going along with the trend from The Breaker, they have to, like, end it off with a bang or with some things going on, because we only have about 2 months left, or 3 months left, actually, I'm sorry, in the year, so it just makes me wonder, like, where are we gonna go from here? But like I said, hopefully he trains with Elder Quan and gets a lot stronger, because as we were told, finally, he was the second strongest in the top 10 of the Mirum. So I honestly don't know anybody else who will be a better master. And even though Quan didn't dislike Shiwun, like, he has to, like, teach him now. But another thing I wanted to bring up was, I don't know if you guys caught this. Did you guys notice that he told the other clan that was repairing his key center that maybe they shouldn't give him as much key? And he was telling them that, well, wait, he could be one of the top martial artists in the Mirum. Why would we do that? And I just wonder, like, if they'll address that situation again. Because, honestly, I see no reason to keep his key down. Like, it makes no sense to me, but let me know what you guys think. That's all I have. Just a little bit of my opinion. Also, Zara went on a little rant, but let me know what you guys think, what you're expecting from the series, and thanks for watching.